Hello everyone, in this video you will learn how to make two objects follow each other. She's new. I'm here. Suppose the cyan one is player and the pink one is enemy. The enemy is going to follow the player. Open the script. Since the enemy is supposed to follow the player permanently, commands should be written in update void. Define a game object called target. This is what the object or the enemy wants to follow. Write in update transform point position equal to vector 2 point move towards open close parenthesis. In parentheses, you should write three arguments. The first argument is the object's position itself. The second argument is the target's position, and the third argument is their speed. So write transform point position, target point transform point position, and the speed. For example, 5 times time dot delta time. Do not forget to do this for sure. Do you want to know why? Open the link above. Now you just have to give the script to the enemy and drag the player towards the script's target and press play. You will see if you move the player to any direction, the enemy follows it. There is a problem. If the player stops, the enemy goes inside it, which this shouldn't happen. To prevent this, you should use a method called distance. Open the script and define a float like this. Not that this, but this. Write in update this equals vector 2 point distance and parenthesis. It needs two arguments. The first is this object's position and the second one is target's position. This code is distance code and its job is to calculate the distance between two objects. Now write if distance was greater equal 3, then bring the follow code to its body. After play, you will see that the enemy follows the player and it stops moving with a distance from the player. This distance is that 3 in the script, which you can put any other number instead of it. For the 3D structure, do exactly the same as for the 2D structure. Only in the script, put vector 3 instead of vector 2. Again, give the script to enemy and drag the player towards the script's target. Now after play, you will see the enemy moves towards the player and in a specified distance, it stops. It doesn't matter how many enemies are in the scene, all would stop in this distance.
Which distance?
This distance.
Actually this distance.
Sometimes it's needed when the enemies are moving in a special way, they can recognize the obstacles which are in their way. For this, we use a method called navigation, which we put its tutorial later in the channel. Subscribe to get notified. Next video is about local structure and how two objects locate each other.